What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today. Hey everybody, welcome into today's video where we will be reviewing the massive modular bookshop. This is a LEGO Creator Set 10270. It's called the Bookshop. It's got 2,504 pieces, is for ages 16 and up, and it actually is two separate buildings. You can see where they kind of separate the colors and you can pull them apart and you can display them like this, or you could spread them out in your LEGO city, which I just so conveniently have in the back here. I'm really excited to add these into my LEGO city. I really enjoyed the build. Now, this retails for $179. I'll drop a link in the description below if you want to use my affiliate link to buy this. That would be awesome, or any LEGO sets. But back on topic, this is a really fun build. I built it across about 2 days, and I built this on one day and this on another day. So it was a lot of fun to turn it into more of an experience build, and I think that that's something that larger LEGO sets offer in general. So with that being said, we do have a small selection of minifigures here, and then of course we have the buildings themselves. So let's not take any more time before we get into this review, and let's take a look at those minifigs up first. So with these modular buildings, the characters don't have names, but I'm just gonna call this guy Asher, because to me he kind of looks like an Asher. As you can see, he does have two sides to his head, kind of like a smirk on that side, and then a big book salesman grin on this side. I have to assume this guy is meant to be the book salesman because he has a book here, which of course says Moby Brick, which is funny. You open it up, there's a 1x2 tile that says Once Upon a Time, and for some reason he has flowers in his hands. I don't know if their promotion this month is you get flowers with a book, but in any case, it's a very cool figure. Not too many uncommon parts here or anything like that, but definitely a cool addition to this set. Here we have the kid with his toy plane. The toy plane is kind of meant to actually get stuck in the tree, you can see in the background here, but he does have some short green legs. Of course, his toy plane here, which I've referenced already, and the propeller does kind of spin. You have to push it. It's not like a flick spin kind of thing there. He has a green scarf, which is a very unique, cool piece. You can turn his hat around to show he's got a smile once he gets his plane back. If we lift up that head, I do want to point out how cool the torso is with the banana on it. I don't know why, but that just really sticks out to me and is pretty cool. So now that we've gotten to the end of his little review segment, I'll give him the smile and we'll keep moving on looking at figures. Here we've got Ben. His name isn't Ben, but I'm calling him that because he reminds me of Ben Kenobi. Nothing too special here. I do like the gray beard on that yellow head, and of course the gray hair is cool, but other than that, not too terribly much to say about old Ben here. Here we've got Jenny. Once again, I just like making up names, but this is a cool character. I love that purple torso, and I love the hair too. This hair is exclusive to this set, at least in this color as of this video that I'm aware of. But yeah, it's a really cool hairpiece. You can flip it around and see she's excited over here. And yeah, it's just a really great figure all around. Love this one. And here we have Pam. Don't you love my names I make up for these people? Anyways, we've got dark blue legs, a torso that has shown up in some city sets before. I really like this hair. We do get two sides to the head, but they don't really look all that different. One's just a little smile and one's kind of like a more genuine smile, I guess. I don't know. Still a cool figure, but not much to say. So why don't we get into the actual build itself? Okay, so here we are at street level, and I'm just going to give you a quick 360. If you're new to modulars, all modulars have these black Technic pins on the side so that you can actually connect them together if you want to build like a street or a city. I really like that there's a backyard element to these. I just think it's a very cool look for the both of them. Of course, this pumpkin piece back here is very unique and cool. I really like that. That just clicks in there. And then just to illustrate my point, you can see that this side has holes to accept those black Technic pins like we saw on the other side. So just kind of illustrates how these buildings would go together. That being said, I really like this like diamond pattern here that we see in front of the bookshop's door. We do have some books on a shelf back here. My assistant Jetty is going to zoom in right here. I really like the tree we have here and the planter, and of course the fall leaves that are on the ground too. Now, if you wanted to change the color of the leaves in the tree, you of course could just you know, pick these up and have some studs there. And I like that they're studs because then you can, like, place a minifig there if you're more of a display person than play person. But I do have to talk about the house on the side here. I mean, this house is just amazing. I love these steps that go up and the way they're angled. Of course, the door pushes in so you can have your minifigs walk into their home here. And we will look at the interiors in just a moment here, but I had to go ahead and show you the outside so we can start to appreciate the inside as we work our way up. While we're on the exterior here, I do want to point out that there is not a single sticker in this set. That's really amazing. So we have birch and books here on two 2x4 flat pieces. Love the accented gold pieces on the sides. We get one of these triangle pieces that says 107. Not sure if that's significant or anything to the set. I love the fall leaves color on the trees, of course. And then there's a really cool little bluebird piece that goes up there. We could see that up close. And you build his nest by putting a little stud there, but it uses Kraven the Hunter's like neck piece, which is kind of cool. So you just sit that on there, and then you put the bird on there, and then the actual nest piece can't move at all. I really love the architecture of the windows on both sets, especially this one up here. It just looks so regal, and it's really an amazing, amazing build. So we're just gonna do another quick 360 so you can see around the back. There is a little patio porch for the people that live here, of course. And then there's a little, I don't know if I would call it like a diner because this is an apartment as well, but it's cool to have these out here. The only thing I hate is that, like, man, these Lego figures would have to be really skinny to get into those chairs, but I get why they had to build it that way. Anyways, that's a quick overview at the tops of these buildings. And let's go ahead and start taking a look at the interiors. Now, these modulars are never easy to review because it's so hard to get a perfect angle to show you everything. In fact, the best angle is usually the one while you're building it. So once it's actually built, it's so hard to see inside. But anyways, let's start with the little living area over here. I really love that there's a little like umbrella that hangs there on two microphones. Of course, there's a hat hung up. I love the little day bed over here. Put a minifigure there so you can see what that would look like. I think that's very cool. Of course, there's a newspaper here and some teapots that look really nice. We do have a fireplace over here and then a little spice cabinet here. Then, of course, there are some steps that go up. But before that, we can take a look and see that there's actually a basement on this side, which is really, really cool. I love that. So here we have a ladder that, you know, can go like this. And of course, that ladder can be brought up front so that you can help the kid get the plane out of the tree. You see how that works? So let's go ahead and put that ladder back where it belongs. Then there's a little mouse trap right there, which is fun. There's some scissors hanging up, presumably for the garden back here. A little bag, not really sure what that's for. Of course, there's some steps that go up and would take you up to that top floor again. And I really like too that there's actually a door back here, kind of like a cellar door, so you have a way to get in or out from the outside too. That is, if you're a minifigure. I don't think anybody watching this video is small enough to actually fit in this building. But that being said, it is a very cool house on that side. Then, of course, on this side, we do get a book store, which is, you know, the name of the set itself. You can lift this up and see more of the bookstore, actually, which is quite cool. So I'll tilt it forward so that you can see. You actually build the books into the wall, so none of them actually come out. And that's one complaint I have about this set. This guy holding this book, this is the only physical Lego book that this set actually comes with. Like, how do you get a bookstore set that only comes with one book? That's really lame to me. But we do get this very nice bookshelf here, which you can lift up and take out if you wanted. I don't know that that's necessarily the intended goal, but you can. I love the floor here, which gives you that nice, like, gold crisscross pattern with the yellow in there. Of course, there's a clear door up front that does open outward to allow your minifigs in. And yeah, I like the old cash register there. That's very cool. Now you'll see that there are some spiral stairs that go up. And then, like I said, you can actually lift this piece off, which I find quite interesting because there's actually a bookshelf up here, which implies that this is still part of the store. And as you'll see in a minute, this leads to another floor for both buildings. So why don't we zoom out and take a look at that now? Okay, so here we have this next level, and I initially thought that this was supposed to be like another living area, but I guess it's just somewhere that your characters can like come up the steps to read a book. I'm really not sure because there's no, like, door here or anything for privacy, so it's very hard to say, but there is a cool grandfather clock that's built into the wall. Of course, a little coffee cup, a nice little reading lamp there, and I really like this recliner chair. You can see that the chair moves back and forth, so you could put a minifigure in there just like that. As I mentioned before, there's a door that opens out this way and then comes to the top floor, which, of course, is like this. So you can see that there's these studs. That's how every floor builds up. You just add another layer. So for this one, you just lift off the entire back, and then when you walk up, there's a bed here and a cool little case with an iguana in it, which is quite cool. I like that, but it confuses me if this top floor, like, when I say this top floor, I mean this area. Is this somebody's house? Because there's like a bed here. Just doesn't make a lot of sense to me. It's not as cut and dry as the blue side is. And speaking of which, why don't we zoom over and take a look at that now? All right, so on the blue side, you'll remember that there are some steps that come up, and then we put on two pieces here. So there's the front piece, and here's the back piece, and let's adjust our camera so it's a little bit more comfortable to look at. All right, so here we go. You can still see the living room down here and the steps that come up, and of course, you can have your figures walk up. There's a nice vintage style dresser here, and then of course, you can put your figures in bed, and I'm not doing this to be risque or anything, but you can actually fit two minifigs in the bed, which is quite rare because a lot of beds are just built for one person. I'm not suggesting anything risque, I'm just pointing out it's interesting that you could fit two people on the bed. There's a little picture right there, and then you add on the back piece just like that, and then this door opens and there's a nice little balcony here. So it's a very cool set. I really like how simple it is for such a large build, especially coming in at around $200 with tax. But with that being said, let's zoom out and I'll give you my final brief thoughts on this set. All right, guys, well, needless to say, I really enjoyed this build. Is it my favorite modular? No, not even close, but I did enjoy the build, and at the end of the day, that's all LEGO is really about. So drop a comment below, let me know what you guys think of this modular, and like I said earlier, if you plan to get this, check out the affiliate link in the description below to help support my channel at no extra cost. All right, guys, thanks for hanging out with me. I'll see you on the next video, and until next time, build on. If you liked what you saw and you liked what you heard, feel free to click that subscribe button for more LEGO videos coming in the near future.